time. Now, if you're managing the one heel, try for the two. Needs a little concentration, especially with those weights. You're really feeling super strong. Take your arms out at the same time. And then we hold it. Can you go deeper? Keep your balance. Well done, doing great. And steady out of it. And here, you might find it helpful to just roll your shoulders and just give a little bit of an ease out of your arms so you feel quite relaxed there. So we'll finish this section now with a slightly stronger bicep curl. Arms in front and touch your shoulders. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Again, if you wish, you can return to the squat. So we're aiming to keep the arm parallel to the floor and not moving the elbow out or whatever, just keeping the arm parallel, touching the shoulders, deepening the squat perhaps, taking the arms out. Nice, strong, deep squat. Holding it down if you wish, and coming maybe up and down, just small lifts up and down. Now that's it. Hold it, go deeper if you can. Release your arms, can you touch the floor? If you can keep your heels down, do so. And we'll draw up the weights all the way up to the chin. Bend the knees all the way down. Bring the weights close to your body. And as we do this, it's a great practice for lifting. So if we need to lift, we should squat or lunge and bring whatever object, even if it's a very small or light object, bring it into your body. So we're not rounding, I'll just take my weights away to demonstrate you're not rounding or hunching and coming up, because with something that you're wanting to lift, you would need to be really careful. So you try and go round with your squat. If it's a heavier object, bring it close to your body and come up. So this is a very good reason now for building leg strength. Have a little bit of an ease out. And we'll take a standing quadricep stretch today. If you're unbalanced, feel free to lie down. So check your pelvis is square. Take your arm, one arm into the air, and the opposite leg behind you. Focus on what we call a drishti point in yoga. A point in front of you that is not moving, and focus on that. Four deep breathing. Now I've still got my socks on. They are yoga socks with the stickers on the bottom to help you keep stable, but you might find you're better off without your socks, and you might prefer not to stand on a mat, especially if it's a thick spongy mat. So switch your side, and find your balance, and breathe calmly. And slowly come out of it. Good. So we're ready now to come to the floor. Take a squat, take your hands behind you if you need to. Otherwise, separate your knees and see if you can sit down nice and slowly with control. So find a midway position on the mat. So we're going to do some roll down. So pelvic floor is in hollow. Scoop out in your stomach muscles. And then lift back up and stretch. So pelvic floor draws up, navel towards spine, roll forward and stretch up. Always lengthen, drop the shoulders. Now dependent on your capacity, you can roll all the way down. So coming down is easier than coming up. And as we come up, we need to be able to do so with control. So if you found you're trying to come up and you're using a jerk or momentum, this is potentially harmful for your spine, in which case just go back as far as you can, but still roll up slowly and safely. So we need always to work in control. We'll take this a couple more times. But for anybody who feels really strong today, you may like to take your arms behind your head. Just move the ball there out of my way. Stretch the arms, draw up on the pelvic floor. bicycle roll down, a Pilates roll down. And of course, if you're stronger, feel free to always come into the stronger positions if you know them.